Hi, I'm Greg McMillan. Thanks for visiting McMillanRunning.com. In this video, we're going to talk to you about speed work. Many of you have probably done some speed work before, or at least you've heard about it. Maybe you ran track in high school, or maybe you go to a local speed work group in your hometown. The challenge is knowing exactly what pace you should be running based on your makeup as a runner so that you get the proper physiological benefits from the workout. Speed workouts involve a series of runs between 1 and 6 minutes done right at your maximal oxygen consumption, which is also called your VO2 max. This usually works out to be right around what you could race for about 10 to 15 minutes. Running at this pace increases your body's ability to process oxygen, a key component to distance running success. Speed workouts are a great part of any training plan, no matter what distance you like to race, because they work on a zone that we often leave dormant, especially us adult runners. I believe all runners should do at least some speed work, no matter what distance they're training for. Here you'll see Kellen Johnson doing a really tough speed workout. She's running 6x800 meters at a pace that falls right in the middle of her suggested speed workout pace, according to the McMillan Running Calculator. Kellen is a speedster though, and that's important to know. You'll see that we have speed workout paces listed under two different categories, speedster and endurance monster. Here's a description of the speedster and the endurance monster. See which one sounds like you. Speedster runners, like Kellen, perform better in fast-paced workouts and shorter races than their more endurance-oriented peers. Long runs, tempo runs, marathon training, and longer races, however, take more out of a speedster than hard track workouts. And they're often frustrated that performances at shorter distances are so good, but as the distance increases, performances suffer. Choose the speedster paces if this sounds like you. For the endurance monster, like McMillan Running ultra marathon coach Ian Torrance, who you see here, long runs, marathon training, tempo runs, and any workout at long distance race paces, they're usually a breeze and often invigorating. The more miles per week, the better is a common mantra for this type of runner. The endurance monster, however, finds it very difficult to get the legs to go fast. Short, fast training like speed workouts leave him often feeling deflated. The endurance monster finds short races to be very difficult, but loves and performs better in the longer races. Choose the endurance monster paces if this sounds like you. So we recommend that anyone trying speed work for the first time start with short repeats, maybe 1 minute in length, before gradually going a bit longer. Again, 6 minutes is about as far as you'll want to take a repeat at this pace. So like everything in running, be conservative when you start speed workouts. Over time, you'll learn to love them, particularly since you now know whether you're a speedster or an endurance monster. Good luck and enjoy fulfilling your need for speed.